गुड आफ्टरनून ऑल. टुडे वी हैव विद अस डॉक्टर के सिंह. ही इज द प्रिंसिपल साइंटिस्ट प्लांट एंड एनिमल न्यूट्रिशन डिवीजन ICAR IGFRI झांसी. सर इज गोइंग टू डिलिबरेट ऑन लो ग्रेड रफेज टेक्नोलॉजी, बेसिकली लो ग्रेड रफेज एंड देयर वैल्यू एडिशन टू वेरियस ट्रीटमेंट. प्लीज कंटिन्यू सर, यू हैव ऑल द कंट्रोल. Your slides are visible and you are also visible and your audio is audible. Please start.
Thank you. Good afternoon. In this session, I will discuss low-grade roughage and their value addition. And in the part, I will also discuss fodder conservation. So I will be a bit fast as we have to cover both topics. In the question, why we think of improving low-grade roughage? It means because we have more than 60-70% contribution of this material in the livestock feeding. So we have to think about how we can improve their utilization in the feeding system. And the major objective of improvement of low-grade roughage is one, to increase the intake, and another, to increase the nutrient utilization. These two objectives must be fulfilled while improving the low grade roughage so that we can utilize the maximum what is present in the low grade roughage. And if you see the livestock population, most of the people, you are knowing that how much and where we are. So in this cattle, buffalo, sheep and goat, we have also mentioned their position in world. And to keep all these animals live healthy and productive, we have to utilize maximum of available fodder resources. And these are the three major fodder resources which are usually used in the animal feeding system: agricultural crop residues, which we are talking to improve, and then bit cultivated fodders and some of the grassland, pasture lands and forest lands. And the role of grassland, pasture lands, forests are in most of the our areas are very low level, but in some parts, in especially in hilly areas, there still exist grasslands, pasture lands. So keeping all these points in view, and at present we need almost this much amount of green and dry fodder to meet the country's requirement. And there is a deficit of approximately 64% green fodder and 25% dry fodder. And to meet all these requirements, we have some estimates. And according to that, we have to talk about paddy straw, wheat straw, sorghum store, maize store, some grasses, sugarcane tops, other lignocellulosic material which are normally used in the livestock feeding system. And if you look at the chemical composition of these low-grade roughage, you will find cell wall portion, which is highest in amount, about 81, 73, and 79. Means all these are, if you convert in percentage, these are the percentage. So you can think of about the utilization of cell wall portion. And among the cell wall, hemicellulose and cellulose portion particularly, because due to lignification of these materials, the utilization of cellulose portion is hampered in the ruminant system. So there are various techniques which are used to improve the either intake or intake and diversity both, that we will discuss in next part. These are the some projection, what type of low grade roughage we are going to get from our agriculture lands. Wheat straw, most of the chances are there increasing amount we are going to get. And the paddy straw, rice straw, these are also we are going to get in increasing trends. So we are will get in future also in higher amounts. While the if you talk about the sorghum straw store, then the trend is showing some decreasing, means we will get some lesser amount in coming days. And then there are various methods, some of the physical which we are normally using at our home or at our field at our livestock complex. For example, chaffing, grinding, compacting and pelting. Some of the companies are producing these materials, means pelted and compacted heats. But chaffing we generally do at our homes and at our dairy farms. And some feed materials are also available in ground farm. But among these, chaffing is very common. While companies and large farms are doing grinding, compacting and pelting also. Among chemicals, we have used sodium hydroxide, ammonia, urea and some enzymes. And among microbial treatments, we have used fungal, but due to high dryium loss, 40 to 60%, we don't recommend such type of treatment. And other methods means there are some of the crop residues have been inside with higher moisture forage crop, but the all depends upon the feasibility of the available systems. So in detail we mostly discuss first we discuss compaction or densification. These are the simple block farms, and they increase the bulk density. The major profit of this increasing bulk density is mostly in transportation and storage space. As due to compaction, both storage space and transportation becomes easy. Since it is only compaction, so we cannot much improve the intake and digestibility of the nutrient. But in case of calamities, we can use such methods to transport and make available these materials to the affected areas. So these are the methods which are used generally to transport the material and restrict the storage space availability. And next is complete feed block. It is made up of mixing of some of the low grade roughage like wheat straw, paddy straw, stover and grasses, and we along with some of the concentrate ingredients, either ready-made concentrate or their ingredients in specified proportions, they are mixed and compacted in complete feed block machine. Usually we keep the pressure 3000 to 500 psi, and size of block is mostly 3 to 5 kg depending upon the chaff length and the type of material we are going to block. And the ratio, depending upon the requirement of the livestock, we put concentrate ratio with the roughage. And normally we use around 30-70 or 40-60. 40-60 for the producing animals, either growing or milk producing animals. And so in this method, it is easier to store again, and transportation is easy, and distribution to the animal is also easy. We offer 2 to 3 blocks depending upon the size of the animal, and it suffices the requirement for the 24 hours. Next is use of fibrolytic enzyme. Now it is a mostly recent research, and people are trying to use some of the enzymes like cellulase, xylanase and pectinase are their mixtures to improve or break the cellulose, hemicellulose and lignin bonds. And up to some extent it is successful. We cannot say that it is 100% success, but it's till date it is bit costlier, although dose is very small, 3 to 5 gram per kg feed dry matter. Moisture don't require much moisture, 3 to 5% as is preferred over 10%, which are already present in the dry material. In general, dry material contains about 10% moisture, so we have to add 3 to 5% depending upon the environmental temperature and other variables. Treatment duration 2 to 12 hours. We generally don't treat and keep it for long period, so we have to just treat in the evening and feed them in the early morning up to 12 o'clock. So it retains moisture, enzymes, and the reaction, whatever is going to happen, is completed within the period. Animal type, mostly during these days, poultry and pigs are feeds are treated by these enzymes, but in large ruminants we are also tried at our institute, but we don't get any significant change in their eating pattern or in the productivity or in the digestibility. So these methods are in the primitive phase. I hope in near future it will get a bit cheaper and also effective in terms of improving the digestibility and intake of the nutrients. And these are the some of the examples where we have conducted some trials. Then we'll find growth performance, feed gain ratio, and final body weight. These are bit better in case of enzyme treated roughage group. Then mostly widely used method is urea treatment, and urea is also available at every doorstep. And next is it's very easy. It don't require much technical know-how, and since most of the low-grade roughage are low in nitrogen, so by treating low-grade material with urea, we add some nitrogen in the feeding material. So this technique is bit better than all others. And in this process, most of the urea, with the help of moisture and urease enzyme, which is already present on all the feed materials, and it converted into ammonia and carbon dioxide. This ammonia reacts with the hydrogen bonding between lignocellulose material, and it breaks the hydrogen bond. So the lignin and cellulose, these two becomes separate, and the utilization by microbe is possible of these materials. And normally what we can say for the user, generally it takes only few days. Like if the environment is colder, then it takes 21 days or 3 weeks. If the environment is bit hotter, means 25 degree or above, then we can go for 14 days, or at even higher temperature we can go for 7 days. So depending upon the environmental temperature, this is the time required to treat the low-grade roughage with the urea of the ammonia. In this process, we take 3 to 4 kg urea, dissolve it into 40 to 50 liters of water, and spray on the 1 quintal of material. So for the one treatment of 1 quintal material, we require 3 to 4 kg urea, 40 to 50 liters of water, and we make the solution and then spray using Hazara or any other spraying system. And after spraying all these materials, we again make a heap and cover the heap with the polythene or any other material, so that ammonia, which is released from the urea due to urease enzyme, it cannot escape, and we keep the heat for 7 to 21 days for the reaction of the ammonia to lignocellulosic materials. And then we make heap, as you know, and after making heap, we cover it, and after 7 days to 29 days, depending upon the environmental temperature, we get our material like this. This is the right hand side, you can see the fresh material. In the left hand side, it is the urea treated material. And effect on straw store, what you can see, there is change in color. It is either brown or brown to black in color. And it is bit moist, as you have added moisture in the material. And normally what you can, we look that it improve the cellulose solubility, which is broken down by the rumen microbes. And the energy part is become available. Since urea is very soluble in water, so some of the nitrogen also microbe get from the treated material. So since treatment increase the availability of nitrogen as well as energy, so the overall improvement in the system you can find. And there is a sufficient scope to use this method without any hazardous effect. And these are the some examples where different supplements on growth performance has been tested. Untreated straw, urea treated, these are the type of supplements. Wheat bran, and daily growth rate, you find almost double here. 110 against 228 grams. While in other case, when supplemented with cotton seed cake or green bursin, you will find better performance of ammonia or urea treated straw against the non-treated straw. So we can say that while in the milk production, again we'll find bit better effect of the urea treated straw on milk production, and you can see the percent change in the milk. It has improved from 45 to 66, 87 and 145, depending upon the material. Then suppose if you want to utilize it, improve the further how much, then you use some additional material, means you have to add some bypass protein in the form of cotton seed cake, 500 to 100 kg per day. And it is a bit slow degradable nitrogen, so it provides nitrogen for the longer duration in the rumen, and this normally enhance the performance in terms of digestion. And it also, when digestion improves, then it also affects the intake in the phytonutrients. And some of the green fodders, like whatever available, particularly legumes in your region, barsim, lucerne, cowpea, or any other green legume, you can supplement 2 to 10 kg depending upon the availability, type of animal, and the physiological status of the animal. So you can get better performance by the supplementing green legume along with treated urea. And one is biological treatment, because we don't recommend this as it normally reduce the dry matter availability, as the fungus itself eats most of the dry matter, 40 to 60% for their own purpose. So remains we don't get any material, which is better than the in comparison to untreated istra. And then some people tried inciting of Crassulaceae with high moisture forage crops like oat, barsim, and it is a good if one can conserve the material. In this ratio is important, 10 to 20% of the dry material and 80% or 80 to 90% you can get. So the dry material as a work as a absorbent, and it absorb the moisture. And since the available sugar in the green material is fermented, some of the lactic acid is produced and it is conserved. By this way, one can improve the utilization of low grade roughage in the ruminant system, but it is not much common, but some people are using these technologies at their farms, and they are getting some of the good material, as the both intake and digestibility of the both the material improves in this process. Thank you. Now we will shift to conservation part. Now we'll talk about some of the parts, important parts related to fodder conservation. Why we need conservation? As you know, conservation, we mostly conserve our resources. For example, what we earn, and we must conserve some part for their future. Likewise, in India, when there is a three different seasons, and in one season we get sufficient fodder, while in other season we don't get much fodder. So this technique is most suitable for the even distribution of green fodder throughout the year. And further, when there is sufficient availability or excess availability, then we have to use judiciously, as we are going to get less in the coming season. So for the judicious use of fodder during abundance to secure future feeding program, this is the major objective of the fodder conservation. And why fodder conservation? To build up fodder reserve, quality fodder supplement, to utilize excess fodder during lean period, to store and enable extended use of potentially unstable material. As the green material has contains high quantity of moisture or water, we cannot keep it for the long period. So by conserving using silage or any methods, we can use this material for the longer duration. And there are two methodologies. One is wet conservation method, that is called silage making, and another is dry conservation as hay. So these two different process. In one, we generally conserve under moist condition, while in case of hay, we generally reduce the moisture level up to 10 to 12%, so it can easily be stored. And what is silage? Silage is a product of controlled fermentation, means there is a controlled fermentation under anaerobic condition. During this process, the water-soluble carbohydrates are converted by the lactic acid bacteria into organic acid like lactic acid, acetic acid, some of the butyric acids, and the combination of all these acids preserve the fodder. So in this process, important part is anaerobic condition. how we can create a good anaerobic condition so that lactic acid bacteria become active. And is there really a need during these age? We can say it is the only method by which we can supply the green fodder throughout the year if we follow some of the steps. Particularly in tropics, it is most important. Earlier we think that it is for the temperate countries, but now we think that it is most suitable for the temperate countries because there is seasonal availability of green fodder, and most of the time we experience fodder shortage due to one or other reasons. And if we talk about the important fodder crops suitable for the ensiling, then best crop is maize, followed by oat, sorghum, millets, and some of the perennial grasses. And and nowadays we are trying here to conserve our range grasses also. Some of the lines which are having sufficient water soluble carbohydrate, it has been identified, and we are trying to conserve range grasses also. And what is silo? Silo means the structure in which we prepare silage. This is called silo. These are the different types: below ground trenches, below ground pits, and above ground trench, and some of the bunkers. Mostly bunkers are suitable for the countries or the person which have good amount of equipment for the conservation purpose. And normally we use below ground trench or above ground material. Other types of silos: kaccha silos, plastic or drum silos. Nowadays plastic silos are mostly used in the commercial condition, and they use some of the automatic machine for the harvesting, chaffing, and compacting the material in the plastic bags. And it is also available in the market. So the future is of plastic bag silo in India and other developing countries. Size of silo. If you talk about how much space we need for a one cattle or two cattle, then depending upon the bulk density of the material, we can roughly estimate the silo requirement. And since the silage material has 350 kg silage per cubic meter, so depending upon the need or the number of animals or duration of feeding, we can calculate how much silo size we need. And here are two examples. One, assuming 10 kg silage per day for one animal, we need 300 kg per month. So silo size is 1 cubic meter. And if you feed the material at 20 kg silage per day, then you need just double any 2 cubic meter silo. Accordingly, you can get the amount of silage also around 300 kg or 600 kg, depending upon the number and the duration. These are the some of the factors which affect the silage fermentation. The most important is water soluble carbohydrate, which must be above 7 for the preparation of good quality silage. And the buffering capacity of the forage must be lower than 200 or between 200 to 300. And moisture content between 65% to 70%, or in some of the tropical forage, we can go up to 60%. and water soluble carbohydrate content. This is for the reference maize 22, oat 16, sorghum 8, millet 7, barsim 5, lucerne 4, range grasses 2 to 4. But we have identified some lines which are having 6 to 8% water soluble carbohydrate, and so we are able to conserve these material also. Tree leaves generally contains low amount, 2 to 3% water soluble carbohydrate, and buffering capacity, for example, buffering capacity normally maize is having very low, 150 to 300 milliequivalent, grasses 250 to 500, legumes 350 to 650. Means legumes have protein, high protein, and this protein is degraded into peptides and ammonia. This ammonia ultimately increase the buffering capacity. Means when high protein material we conserve, they are resist to change in pH. That resist to change in pH, that is called buffering capacity. Means they produce an hindrance in dropping the pH. So we choose the crop which are suitable for the conservation purpose. Then how we can estimate the moisture content under field condition? There are three conditions. If we take the chaffed material and compact it by their hands, then if the ball is suddenly opens, if we compact the material and ball is suddenly opens, then we can say that moisture content is too low. Means if the moisture content is too low, then it will be very difficult to compact the material by hands. If the ball remains in shape, and it means moisture content is too high. If you compress the chaffed material by our hands, using both hands or single hands, if the ball remains in its shape, then we can say the moisture content is very high. And in this process, if the moisture content is very high, if you compress the material, you will find some of the juices coming out from your hands. So this is also saying that the moisture content is a bit higher. So you have to reduce while the ensiling process. If the ball opens slowly, and it means moisture content in fodder is suitable to be ensiled. Means if the moisture content is between 60 to 70%, then the balls open very slowly, and you will get bit moisture in your hands also. Bit moisture, but not the flowing moisture. Usually you use 30 to 35% dry matter for the ensiling. And these are the steps in silage making: harvesting and transportation, chaffing, filling and compaction, and then covering and sealing. And harvesting and transportation. Harvesting is the first and very important part of the ensiling. At the proper stage, you have to harvest your fodder. And since fodder mostly contains 80 to 85% moisture, so keep the material in the field for 24 hours or 48 hours, depending upon the climatic condition, or even 6 hours if the temperatures are very high. So the material lose some of the moisture, and you will get it around 60 to 70%, and you will get moisture evaporated due to sun drying. That we call it wilting. Wilting requirement of the material before ensiling. And the if you harvest the at proper stage, 6 to 8 hour wilting is sufficient. For example, maize 50% flowering to duff stage, sorghum at the same stage, oat move to duff stage. Oat is a thin stem forage, so we harvest it at later part of their life, boot to the stage, grasses early flowering, as the water soluble carbohydrate is maximum at the early stage. These are the some of the harvesting stages for the crops. Then the next process is chaffing. Chaffing is very important because if you inside the long material, then compaction become uneasy. Compaction become difficult. So chaffing, by reducing the particle size, compaction become very complete. And you have to evacuate maximum air which are present between the particles. So chaff length is very important. Normally we use 2 to 3 centimeter, or up to, we can say, go for 2 to 3 inches maximum. And due to better compaction, it favors the growth of lactic acid bacteria, and also helps in evacuating maximum oxygen, which degrade our proteins and other available nutrients. Then filling and compaction. Compaction, if the material is small, then you can trample it by foot. Other, if the material is larger amounts, then you compact it using tractors or any other means. Compaction is very, very essential to get good quality sizes. This helps in evacuation of air. And also check the anaerobic respiration, and helps in creating the anaerobic condition. And then finally, covering. Covering is normally we recommend 45 to 60 days. Keep it covered. And for the thin stemmed material like oat and other material which are thin stemmed, you can use 45 days. And for the coarse material or thicker material like maize, oat, maize and sorghum and millets, you can use 60 days ensiling period. And in 45 to 60 days, your silage material will be ready for the feeding. And after the completion of the ensiling period, if you take the material, silage material, it will be fragile. If you have put it at the right dry matter content, then it will be fragile and greenish to yellow is in color. And it will have a good aroma of lactic acid, means lactic acid, or in some of the fodder crops you will get acetic acid aroma. And after completion of this ensiling process, these material you can get for any number of years, means 2 to 3 years, without any change in the silo. But if you have opened the silo, then you have to use material every day so that you will get some of the damaged upper portion of the inside material in the daily feeding. And after opening from this day, if it don't get mold within 7 or 10 days, then you can say your material is very good. These are the some of the parameters which normally used in the laboratories to define the quality of the silage: good, intermediate or poor. If the silage pH is between 4.2 to 4.8, we can say it is good. Between 4.8 to 5.2, it is intermediate. Above 5.2, we can say poor. Likewise, lactic acid. Lactic acid is minimum requirement is at least 1%. If it is more than 3, then we can say it is good. Butyric acid is not a required organic acid in the ensiling process, but some of the microbes produce butyric acid. Usually, if the concentration is very low, then it is okay. Otherwise, you'll find very brilliant aroma. And these are the some of the ratios which will defined in the laboratories. And this is the how to feed the silage. When you feed the silage to the animal first time, generally animal don't take it easy. So in this process, you have to offer small amount of silage, say for 1/2 kg or 1 kg, along with what you are offering in daily feeding. And after a day or 2 days, 3 days, or sometimes it will take 4 to 5 days or 6 days, then slowly animal try to taste this inside the material. And when taste develops, that animal try to take all your silage, and accordingly you have to reduce the other feed material which we have offered usually. So you can train the animal by a slow offering and reducing your daily offering feed to the animals. And generally avoid silage to newborn calves, particularly below 3 months, as there is no rumen developed properly, and it is a material is acidic in nature. And hay making, next is hay making. Simply, hay making is very simple. It is simply drying of the forage to a very low level of moisture, means less than 15%, so that all the plant activities, chemical activities will stop, all the enzyme activity will stop, and due to that you will be able to preserve the nutrients, and at low level most of the microbial activity also stops. So it is a simple process of drying, but you have to take care during drying that if the there is legume, then there must not be excessive scattering of leaves. These are the some of the suitable crops for like lucerne, oat. Most of the thin stemmed forage you can convert in hay easily, and most of the leguminous fodders are most suitable for the conservation as hay. There is a same harvesting, frequent turning during curing, and stacking. These are the three steps involved in the hay making process. And among these methods, field curing is the most suitable, as is don't involve any extra cost. Harvest in this process, harvest the crop and left in the field for drying under sunlight. And the frequent turning, 1 or 2 turning next day is very essential. Otherwise, when there is high moisture, the crop becomes bit blackish. So frequent turning, particularly 2nd and 3rd day, is most important. And we must turn the material so that every part get equal sunlight. It does not involve calves, so need any specific equipment also. So this field curing is very effective method. If the weather is clear, then this field curing method could be used for the making of hay. Then tripod method, if there is no facility or weather is not supporting, then we use such type of methods. But tripod, now you can say laundry hanger type material for drying of cloth that we use. And here we use some of the structure tripod to dry the crop material. But these involve some of the cost, some of the structures. And Otherwise, all requirements of turning is same. The most effective tool tripod is that it provides aeration from all the direction, so the drying become faster due to proper aeration from all sides. Drying is faster, and but bit costly as compared to the field curing. Advantage of hay making: fodder can be preserved for longer period of time. There is no change in the material after proper drying. Good quality legume hay may replace some of the amount of concentrate in the ration when there is no availability of other fodders, and you can reduce your cost also by using hay. It does not involve cost specific equipment and can be prepared at any site or production itself. Means if you are using field curing method, then there is no need of any specific equipment, and you can prepare hay at any place where crop is harvested. But one requirement that you must keep weather condition in your mind before harvesting the crop. Otherwise, it will damage your crop. It will become some moldy or blackish in color. So while preparing hay, you must keep in mind that weather must be clear at least 5 to 7 days in next coming time. Thank you. हेलो हाँ हाँ जी हाँ जी कुछ अभी जरूरी है तो बताइए, नहीं थोड़ा देर में बात कीजिए. चलिए देखते हैं, अभी तो मैं एक लेक्चर में हूँ तो अभी निकलता हूँ. नहीं अब हमें याद रहेगा, अब देखते हैं क्या है. हाँ हाँ नहीं जानते हैं. हेलो
थैंक यू सर. थैंक यू. थैंक यू ऑल पार्टिसिपेंट्स. डू यू हैव एनी क्वेश्चंस रिगार्डिंग द प्रेजेंटेशन? इफ देयर एनी क्वेश्चंस प्लीज आस्क. Any questions, please ask. Sir, I don't think there are any questions. On behalf of NADCL and IGFRI, and on the behalf of participants, sir, I would like all to thank you for being with us and sharing insights into the topic. Thank you, sir. Thanks a lot. We may consider this presentation to be over and participants may leave. Thank you.